What a year 2012 has been for our chapter. We are fortunate to have a very involved board with a strategic plan and balanced scorecard, but this year we moved more items into the 100% target column than in any previous year. A few years ago, our board read the book Good to Great, and I really feel that Alabama chapter has now moved the dial from good to great. We are an active board that is moving our goals forward and working together to inspire pediatricians and our patients for quality improvement, advocacy, and improved health for children in Alabama. We started 2012 with a looming deficit in our Medicaid program and the loss of a Medicaid director friendly to physician interests, with a hostile legislature and ambivalent governor. Our legislative day was a disaster. Our Republican-controlled legislature was angry with our chapter. Medicaid, mental health, public health, and human resources all stood to lose a lot in the budget process. This woke the sleeping lion of chapter membership grassroots advocacy. Through our e-newsletter and president's video messages, the chapter office got out the message about patient advocacy to our members within days of our legislative day. Practices had advocacy stations in the waiting rooms of offices, pediatricians spoke to chambers of commerce, and numerous editorials were written to papers throughout the state of Alabama. One office crashed their legislator's fax server. Our Republican-led legislature crafted a constitutional amendment to transfer funds from savings to rescue Medicaid, as well as other health and child service agencies. The chapter partnered with 18 organizations through a Keep Alabama Working campaign to get out the message about passage of the amendment to protect Medicaid. There were so many local pediatricians writing editorials, our political consultants decided not to have official editorials sent out from the campaign office. Brochures and letters went out to every physician office in the state. The amendment passed 2-1 in a fiscally conservative state that hasn't passed a funding amendment in at least 16 years. Our chapter developed a media plan over the last 2 to 3 years, and effective use of our e-news, videos, print, radio, TV, and social media skyrocketed our chapter's visibility. Our increased visibility has made us a player in the plan to improve and reform Medicaid, as well as give it long-term funding stability. Our chapter VP sits on both the legislature and governor's Medicaid advisory commissions, in addition to appointees from the Medical Association. The social media connections we have built are valuable tools in our future advocacy for child health. We are now a much more visible force for change in Alabama, as well as being the go-to place for information by the media. All of this would be enough for 1 year, but we still managed to pull off our 2 CME meetings, work on CQN2 asthma, plan CQN3 asthma that will have a home visiting component, continue to develop an MOC collaborative for developmental screening in 2 phases, and begin collaboration on QI for obesity with Blue Cross, which we also hope will be the building block for a child health improvement partnership with funding and dedicated staff support. We also secured a teen driving grant from Allstate to give pediatricians practical tools to educate teens on safe driving and held a statewide news conference that spurred dozens of media hits. And Reach Out and Read practices across the state promoted physical activity this summer with fun activities using the book Barnyard Dance. In the midst of all of this, the chapter continued to dedicate this year to making the business case for expanding care to the underserved, with a panel discussion about satellite clinics for rural and underserved populations at our fall CME meeting. We've also committed to having a more active board. The chapter representatives to 28 state agencies and commissions formally report to a board member to streamline communication. Our board has taken an active role in administering responsibility for our Reach Out and Read program, and we'll be continuing with additional board governance and leadership training in January at our yearly strategic planning meeting. In order to reach new members, we've been working with our faculty liaisons to the board from both of our residency training programs. We have dedicated a spot for a pediatric subspecialist on our pediatric council, and the chair of the Department of Pediatrics at University of South Alabama is now our co-chair for CME. We have had president videos about encouraging colleagues to support advocacy by joining, because our advocacy work doesn't happen without staff support, which is funded through dues. It has been a truly great year for the Alabama chapter. We are so proud of what we've accomplished this year and look forward to using our momentum to bring about improved child health across Alabama.